Okay, in this video we are going to study about Lami's theorem and its application with the vectors. Okay, so first of all let's understand what is Lami's theorem. So it is applicable for a triangle, or it is also applicable for three vectors whose vector sum is 0. Okay. So how do you apply Lami's theorem for a triangle? First, let's see. If I take a random triangle, okay, this is a random triangle whose sides are A, B, and C, and the angle opposite to side A is alpha, angle opposite to side B is beta, angle opposite to side C is gamma. Then I can say that A by sine alpha equal to B by sine beta equal to C by sine gamma. This is how you use Lami's theorem in a triangle. Now, how do you apply this Lami's theorem in case of vectors? So for vectors it can be applied in two ways. So let's take three vectors, A vector plus B vector plus C vector equal to 0. Sum of the three vectors is 0. So this is my A vector. Okay, then from the head of A vector I draw B vector, correct? So this is my B vector, and finally this will be my C vector. Okay, then this triangle is similar to this one, right? This is side A, this is vector A, this is side B, this is vector B, this is side C, this is vector C. And again, if I draw the same angles, alpha over here, beta over here, and gamma over here, then I can again write the same equation for this vector as well. So let's just copy this. So exactly same equation is applicable for vectors also. But in case of vectors, I can apply Lami's theorem in two ways. So this is one way of applying Lami's theorem. So I'll write this as, this is method 1 for triangle, this is method 2 for vectors, and again I will write down method 3 for vectors. What do I do? Again, I want three vectors whose sum will be 0. Okay, now let's put the three vectors together. But now their tails should be connected. Okay. Their tails should be connected. Okay. This is the head of the vector A. Okay. Then we have vector B. Actually, I should duplicate this. So this is your vector B. Okay. And finally, we have the vector C. I'll duplicate this and put that over here. Okay, so this is my vector C. Now in this case, so again let's copy the original diagram also, because we will be needing it over here. Why we will be needing it, you will understand. So let's extend this line. Then how much is this angle? This angle will be 180 degree minus beta. So this angle over here will also be 180 degree minus beta. Okay. Then extend this line over here along B vector. Then this angle will be how much? 180 degree minus alpha. So this angle over here will also be 180 degree minus alpha. Okay. And let's extend the line over here. Then this angle will be what? 180 degree minus gamma. So this angle over here will be 180 degree minus gamma. Correct. Now there's a property of trigonometry that sine 180 degree minus theta is equal to sine theta. So sine 180 minus alpha will be sine alpha, 180 minus beta will give you sine beta, and sine of 180 minus gamma will give you sine gamma. So again we have the same thing we just proved, right? that we just wrote it this way, a by sine alpha equal to b by sine beta equal to c by sine gamma. So same thing we can write over here. But now a by sine alpha will be also equal to sine 180 minus alpha equal to b by sine beta will also be equal to sine 180 minus beta equal to c by sine gamma. So that will be replaced by sine 180 minus gamma. Okay. So a divided by sine of angle opposite to it. So if I name the angles again, I name this angle as A and I name this angle as capital B and name this angle as capital C. So I can write down A by sine A equal to B by sine B equal to C by sine C. Okay. A divided by sine of angle opposite to it is equal to B divided by sine of angle opposite to it equal to C divided by sine of angle opposite to C vector. Okay. So this is how you write down the Lami's theorem. So these are three ways of writing Lami's theorem: for triangle, for vector, and again for vector when vectors are drawn like this, tail to tail connection. Okay. Now I will prove how the Lami's theorem comes into existence. Okay. So first we will prove for a triangle. Okay. If you prove for this triangle, then you prove for this vector as well. Okay. But let's try to understand. So let's take the triangle again. This is side A, side B, side C. This is angle alpha. This is angle beta. Now let's drop a perpendicular from this vertex over here. This is 90 degree. Okay. So for this triangle, the red colored height will be how much? Let's say this is height h. So h will be what? For this triangle, hypotenuse b into alpha. Or let's just draw separately. We can write down that sine alpha equal to h by b. Okay. Sine alpha equal to h divided by b. Similarly, for this triangle, sine beta will be how much? H divided by A. So sine beta will be H divided by A. Okay. So I will get H equal to A sine beta is equal to B sine alpha. From here I get A sine beta equal to H. From here I get B sine alpha equal to H. Okay. So again rearrange this equation. So I got A divided by sine alpha equal to B divided by sine beta. Okay. So I found one part of the theorem correct. Now let's draw this again. So again, now I take this angle as gamma and from this vertex, I have to drop a perpendicular. So this is 90 degree over here. Correct. Now, sine gamma will be what? So if I name this perpendicular as, let's say, h dash. So sine gamma will be h dash divided by a. So h dash divided by a. What about sine alpha? So for this triangle, sine alpha will be h dash divided by c. So I get h dash divided by c. This is sine alpha. Then I can write down h dash equal to a sine gamma is also equal to c sine alpha. Then if I rearrange this equation, I will get a by sine alpha equal to c by sine gamma. So combining this equation and this equation, what do I get? I will get a by sine alpha equal to b by sine beta equal to c by sine gamma. So hence we proved the Lami's theorem for a triangle. Now coming back to this original case, since this triangle is exactly identical to this triangle, okay, except for that here I have drawn sides ABC and here I have drawn vectors AB and C. So it doesn't make a difference. This side is still A, this side is A, this side is B, this side is B, this side is C, this side is C. So this same formula is applicable for this vector triangle as well. And for this third situation, if we know this formula, then it's very easy to derive this formula, okay, that we just did. So all three conditions have been derived, okay.